my room, so I've got this little pumpkin microtech for like $3. It still works fine and plays in. And so, so it feels kind of styrofoam, like harder, more firm than usual loose styrofoam, but I feel like I can cut different shapes through it, maybe, hopefully. So I'm going to try to attempt this time to cut this into a 1978 Halloween movie, which I can't remember. When it's in here, I was going to outline the shapes according to the shapes of the jack-o'-lantern. And if you notice, they're not fully circular, the eyes. They're more flat at the bottom, so I'm just going to re-bent how it is. So, because the shape of the nose is actually the opposite, upside down, which is pretty odd, I'm just going to draw the opposite shape this way, but it's going to be closer to the eyes than the original jack-o'-lantern is. Alright, so this is not exactly accurate because the mouth is more pronounced, it's smart, and it's not subtle as the one in the movie, so I can't do anything about that, but I did the best I could shaping the teeth around the teeth to cut it. Now the line is also partly cut out, obviously, so let's see if I even cut it, let's see how it goes.
Now, I apologize if it's difficult to see, be very careful, obviously, might want to have some pretty good glass and cut yourself on it. I wanted to do this for a while, but I was afraid I would, when I married, I had left behind, because I left a lot of the hard stuff and gave it away, because it just takes so much room and stuff. And don't worry about the imperfections, like, they can be somewhat, fixed up later on. And then, I'm just going to have to make them a little taller, actually, not leave it up to me. Now, the main problem, which one does these two, it's probably a lot easier to use in Zachary. But
you may think they scare me, you're probably right. Black cats and goblins on Halloween night. Trick or treat!
Take your time with the teeth, because like once if you cut them off, like there's really no way to put them back on. I'm trying to get the whole jaw off here, or whatever, the whole face. Because it's pretty, fragile, honestly. Which is a good thing and a bad thing. At least I can cut through it, but it's just... Okay. There's that one. One little two. Okay, so... What I'm gonna do with this is... I'm just gonna cut a little... slit right down to where the slit is. I call it his cleft lip. That's all I'm gonna think of. I'm just gonna cut a little bit, just enough to where the light will shine through. It should get the job done. If not, you can always cut more, but you can't add more to kill ourselves. Keep that in mind. Like I said, I can't stress this enough. Be very careful when you're doing this. It'll probably be easier on the table, but... Okay, so now work on the mouth. Yeah. Alright, this is it. So I know that this model is a lot more, pronounced in this. That's because there's nothing I can do with the shape that was remaining there already. But I mean, it gets the gist of it. It's pretty similar. I guess it's not very exactly like it, but, I think it went pretty well considering all those plastic pumpkin out of cards. And the fact that, you know, there was really little I could do with the mouth. But, anyway, I was hoping I could get a little cut off right here, but I couldn't do that, obviously. But, if you're seeing a pumpkin like this, you could easily do that with the jack-o'-lantern, just like I said, be careful. And then, it's a great accent piece, and they're usually cheap, but, you know, like Goodwills and Mega Thrift, where I got mine. You can probably buy them on clearance, too, after Halloween. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoy it, get some ideas, and come back home. Thank you.